I want to continue the topic motion from the 9th class physical science. In the last class, I told you about the definitions of rest, motion, distance, displacement, and speed. Today, I want to tell you about the velocity or average velocity. Velocity or average velocity of a body can be defined as the displacement of a body per unit time is called as velocity or average velocity of the body. The formula for the velocity or average velocity is equals to displacement by time. When we divide the displacement value with time taken, we get the displacement per unit time. Displacement per unit time, that is called as velocity of the body. So we can solve an example sum based on the formula. If a body covered 360 km due southwest direction in 12 hours, then what is its velocity? In velocity, there must be a particular direction. It is the direction, you know, so it was given, displacement is there. So, by the formula, displacement by time, the displacement is 360 km and the time interval is 12 hours. So, 360 by 12, we get 30 km per hour. The southwest direction. It is the velocity of the body in the southwest direction. Next concept is instantaneous speed. The speed of a body at any instant is known as instantaneous speed. For example, let us consider motion of a car during the time interval from T1 to T2. It has traveled from S1 to S2. The distance covered per T1 time is S1 and the distance covered per T2 time is S2. So what is the speed of the car between the time interval T1 to T2? If you want to know, this is the time interval. T2 minus T1 gives you the time, how much time interval it is. Similarly, S2 minus S1 is the distance covered during the time interval T1 to T2. So the S2 minus S1 is the distance, T2 minus T1 is the time. So the distance by time, we can find the speed during the time interval T1 to T2. This is the speed of the car during the time interval T1 to T2. If I want to know the speed of the car at any particular instant T3, it has traveled S3 distance for the time T3. But I want to know what is the speed at T3? If I want to know the speed at T3, that is called instantaneous speed of the car at T3, if I want to know, I need to consider the time interval which is closer to the T3. These are farther, T1 and T2 are farther to T3. But if I consider the two times, that is T4 and T5, which are encompassing the time T3, before T3, I can enter T4, after T3, I can enter T5. That is the distance covered for T4, T4 is S4, and the distance covered for T5 is S5. By taking the, if I consider the time interval between the T5 and T4, T5 minus T4 is the duration of time. And S5 minus S4 is the distance covered. S5 minus S4 is the distance covered. So that by using the formula S5 minus S4 by T5 minus T4, I can calculate the speed of the car at the time T3. That is what we call instantaneous speed at T3. I can calculate by using this formula. The time interval must consist of or encompassing the T3, at which we need to find instantaneous speed. And moreover, the instantaneous speed also can be represented by plotting a tangent at the point of time. By plotting a tangent, the slope of the tangent at this point gives you the instantaneous speed. If the slope is more, then the speed is more. If the slope of the tangent is less, the speed, instantaneous speed is less. We can calculate by plotting a tangent and finding the slope of the tangent, we can find the instantaneous speed. The next concept is uniform motion. What do you mean by uniform motion? A body motion is to be uniform, then its velocity is constant. The definition of the uniform motion is, the motion of a body is said to be uniform when its velocity is constant. If it maintains same velocity without any variation, without any change in its velocity. Let us consider motion of a cyclist on a straight road. The distance covered with respect to time was calculated here. How we cover the distances with respect to time means, per 1 second 4 meters, per 2 seconds 8 meters, 3 seconds 12 meters, per 4 seconds 16 meters. For every instant of time, if you want to calculate the speed 4 by 1, distance by time, what is 4 by 1, 4 meters we got it. 8 meters per 2 seconds, means 8 by 2, 4 meters per second we got it. 12 meters per 3 seconds, followed by 3, 4 second, 4 meters per second, 16 by 4, 4 meters per second. In all the cases, we got 4 meters per second is the velocity. In this condition, we are observing the velocity of the body is same. Velocity is the speed, velocity of the body is constant. That's why the motion here in the cyclist motion is said to be uniform motion. So, if we plot a graph between the time versus the distance, we got a straight line graph, straight line curve, a straight line which is passing through the origin. It also indicates that the motion of the body is uniform motion. Let us consider another case. This is also the motion of the cyclist who is moving on the straight road. In straight road means distance is considered as a displacement. That's why we are talking about velocity. Distance and displacement both are same. Distance and displacement, anything same, because the motion of the body is in straight road. So how he covered in the case for 1 second 1 meter, 2 seconds 4, 3 seconds 9, for 4 seconds 16 meters. He does not cover equal distances in equal intervals of time. That's why we get a velocity change. For example, 1 by 1, 1 we got, 4 by 2, 2, 9 by 3, 3 we got there, 16 by 4, 4 we got there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, velocity is changing. That's why the body motion is said to be non-uniform when its velocity is changing. This case of the cyclist motion is said to considered as a non-uniform motion. By plotting a graph between time versus distance, we get a curved path, curved shaped graph we get. Based on this curved path, we say it's a non-uniform motion. Okay, did you understood about the uniform motion and non-uniform motion? If the cyclist covers equal distances in equal intervals of time, he maintains the constant velocity. That's why his motion is said to be uniform motion. If the cyclist covers unequal distances in equal intervals of time, the motion of the cyclist then is said to be non-uniform motion. And moreover, for the non-uniform motion where the velocity is being varying or changing, three more examples are here given. One is motion of a ball on an inclined plane is also an example for non-uniform motion. Why? Because in equal intervals of time, he covers unequal distances. Here time being 1 second, here the time factor 1 second. Here also for 1 second only, he covers unequal distances in equal intervals of time. For each second, he covers unequal distances. Whether in the downward direction or in the upward direction also, or an inclined plane, the motion of the ball is said to be non-uniform motion. Why? Because it covers unequal distances in equal intervals of time. That's why it is an example for non-uniform motion. One more example for non-uniform motion is the object which is moving in uniform circular path. The circle is uniformly in having a, that's called, so it is the object moving in uniform circle. It is also an example for non-uniform motion. Why? Because it maintains equal distances in equal intervals of time, but the direction is changing here. When the velocity is concerned, the direction is considered. Here the positive value, here the negative values. Downward negative, upward positive values. Direction is changing means we say velocity is changing. So it is also an example for non-uniform motion. And one more example for non-uniform motion is motion of an object thrown into air. Here both direction and quantity both changes. Here the cover distance per each second is varying in upward direction and downward direction also. And also at every point the direction is changing. Here upward direction, here slightly changing the direction, here downward direction. Both magnitude of distance covered and the direction both are varying here. Here only distance covering is equal, but the direction is changing. That's why velocity is varying here. Here direction is same, but the distance covering is different. That's why these three examples and the cyclist who is covering unequal distances in equal intervals of time, and these all are examples for non-uniform motion.